Armo, founder, owner, the stock swoosh, to talk all about the markets, some names she likes, the bullish names, the bearish names. So let's just start with the big picture here. Melissa, how are you feeling about the markets now when you look at what's going on here?
Big picture markets, I'd say I'm giving it about 2 years, and that's a long time out, for the possibility of another major sell-off in the market. So right now I'm bullish on the market. We're heavy today. We could fall again. We fell yesterday. But you can't deny the fact that the market has been in such a strong uptrend and we've been making new highs and quite a lot, particularly in the SPY. That may be because of the out of Tesla and the strength we've been seeing in the banks this year. But I think that at some point, we are going to see the effects of higher corporate taxes, if in fact this goes through, the lingering unemployment, cities like New York City that have been closed, and even though Mayor de Blasio is reopening them July 1st, I don't think the city is going to come back to normal this year. You're going to see the effects of, again, the foreclosures because they keep pushing back the moratorium on the evictions. At some point, these things always have it takes longer to see the effect of some of these negative implications. Right now, we're seeing job growth and economic growth because of the fact that things have just reopened, because people couldn't go to work because things were closed, not because they didn't want to work. So it's really not new jobs. It's just where it looks like new jobs, but it's not new jobs. We're putting back the same jobs as we had before COVID. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah. So how are you deciding your bullish and bearish lists here? Let's start with the bullish names. I know you have UPS and Target there.
Yeah, UPS and Target, I really, really, really love UPS. That is a strong company. That could easily go to 220, 225. That could even go to 250. They had amazing earnings. And one of the reasons I like UPS is, and Target too, Target made new highs in the last few days as well. Those earnings for Target are May 19th. But UPS is my top bullish watch. And the reason is because it's on its own. It even rallied yesterday when the market sold off. UPS is so strong, it's on its own. And my advice to people out there right now, because I don't know exactly when this effect, like I said, happens, when we have a sell-off in the market, it could happen at any point, or it could be a while from now, is pick selective things to invest in. Pick selective stocks to trade. Pick things that are really, really strong if you're going to go long, or pick things that are really weak if you're going to short. Now, one of the reasons that I also like the bearish picks I picked, which one of them was Netflix, is Netflix had not so great of earnings. For that stock, normally it has a big move on earnings up or down. In this case, it had a big move down in earnings. And even though it hasn't fully broken 500, it's touched it, it's nibbled at it, it's tried to break it, it did a little bit the other day. Once Netflix seriously gets through that 500 level, it has a long way to go down. That stock has had tremendous growth. That stock has over 200 million subscribers. And the problem is, they didn't meet expectations for subscribers. They were supposed to hit, I think, 2 million, and they hit less than that. At some point, they have so many people now that are subscribers. They're trying to grow globally. With the slowing of COVID and people going out more, it's going to be harder and harder for them to keep getting this many new people. And they need a lot of revenue, because remember, Netflix has spent a lot of money on new production and series. In fact, there's some really good series that you can get on Netflix. Once people start to go out more, they may not subscribe continuously like people were last year. So that is my top bearish watch for things to
go. Yeah, I know you have that on there. I thought that was interesting. And, you know, I understand why you have UPS and Target. I mean, we're certainly seeing a lot of shopping and curbside pickup and things that are happening in those. To stay to the downside, in addition to your Netflix call as a bearish call, you also have a few others, including Microsoft, Tesla, and Peloton. Can we start with Tesla?
Well, Tesla's earnings, if you look at the chart, if you like to look at earnings or play stocks on those days, which I like to do, and the reason I like to trade stocks on earnings days is because they tend to have big moves, or the biggest moves, on the day of the earnings or the day after the earnings. Anyways, when you look at Tesla, if you look at the chart, you couldn't even pick out the day of the earnings. It basically was a nothing burger. It really didn't move that much, which is very surprising for that stock. So it really didn't make any sense to me. While they have tremendous opportunity for growth, I think this short term, even though it's an uptrend, short term Tesla can go all the way down to 650, 625, 600 before it goes anywhere back up again to new highs. The next earnings on Tesla are months and months away. So for now, it's trending to the downside. And again, that has a big room to move down to. And that stock, if you've ever traded it, is a lot easier to trade as an option that is an equity trade or swing trade just because of the cost of it.